Okay, so we were discussing the topic intelligent agents. We understand what are the qualities of an agent and what are the features of an agent, what is an intelligent agent. Now, today we will discuss some more concept regarding intelligent agents. So, today's first topic is concept of rationality. What do you understand by rational? Being rational means you are having some reasoning, some logic behind your action, on which basis you have taken some decision or some action performed by you. So let's see what is the concept of rationality in context with the intelligent agents or simply agents. Now people are still coming. Okay, so what is rationality? At any given time, rationality depends upon four things. Rationality means basic reasoning, your logic behind any action or any activity done by you. So you take that decision of rationality based upon some features. What are those features? What are the four things? First one is the performance measures that defines the criteria of success. Means you have taken some action, it decides the performance measure that today you are taking a class of artificial intelligence. This is the reasoning behind taking the class, that you understand some concept regarding artificial intelligence and its subtopic intelligent agents. So it will boost your success criteria in the examination and in your professional career as at a large. So this depends upon the performance measure that defines the criteria of success. This is the first point. Second one is the agent's prior knowledge of the environment. You must have some prior knowledge about the environment on which basis you decide or take some decisions based upon some reasoning. And the next point is the actions that the agent can perform. What are your capability and actions that you can perform that your body and your like five senses can allow you to do? And the last one is the agent's percept sequence to date, means whatever the sequence of actions you have done till now, these are the four features, or you can say four things that depends the rationality basis. And let's see what are the rational agents. We have seen agent, we have seen intelligent agent. Now, what is a rational agent? As you understand that in first class, we discuss that well, if we say that artificial intelligence possessed by the machine, then there are four school of thoughts. First one is what? Think like a human, act like a human, and then what we have? Think rationally and act rationally. Means humans are not always act rationally, though we consider them as a intelligent species. Still, some people do not in all situation act intelligently. So rational means the best possible behavior done by the humans in all scenarios that we consider as a rational behavior. So what is an rational agent? An agent, you better understand that agent is something, some program, some human being or some animals or any non-living beings can act as an agent, means they can work on behalf of you. So let's see what is an rational agent. For each possible percept sequence, a rational agent should select an action that is expected to maximize its performance measure. Given the evidence provided by the percept sequence and whatever built-in knowledge the agent has, means as you understand that in previously rational four features were that you have to maximize the performance. So this rational agent is gonna maximize the performance based upon the percept sequence and the knowledge it possesses previously. So this is the activity done by the rational agent. Now, a rational agent is one that does the right thing. Here we have choose the word as the right thing. Means you are looking for some optimal solution that is the right thing at some situation. So a rational agent is one that does the right thing. For each best possible action, agents gets the positive rewards and for each wrong action, an agent gets a negative reward. Just like in a real situation, also humans, when do some good work, you get a pat from your teacher or your parents. It means you are getting some reward in. You may get some money also as a prize money, and if you there is some you got some back in some paper, so it is a negative reward for some wrong action. So this is the way human learns from their mistakes. So this is the thing we want to implement in the machine also, that if human can learn from their mistakes and can boost their morale based upon their positive actions and appreciation from the others. In this way, machine also, a rational agent, can get rewarded if it do the right thing, and it can get punished if, or maybe rewarded negatively, then if it has done anything wrong. So therefore, a rational agent is an agent which has a clear preference, model uncertainty, and acts in a way to maximize its performance, measures with all the possible actions. So now you must have a clear picture about rational agents, that what are the rational agents. You just think about some like a tool that act rationally based upon its previous database, like previous percept sequence and their previous built-in knowledge. On the basis of that, they look for some optimized performance, on which basis they take some decisions to do or to do something or not to do. So this is the concept of rational agent. Now let's see the task environment. As you know, that we humans are always in some environment in which we are doing some action. Similarly, a machine, or we can say agent, which is acting on behalf of humans, is also must have an environment in which it has to perform some tasks. So let's see what are the ingredients of a environment and how a agent can interact with the task environment. So there is a acronym piece. There is a representation of the 4 points of the task environment. First one is P for performance measure, E for environment, A for actuators, and S for sensors. P, performance measure, you better understand that you have to judge the agent's performance. E is the environment, that is in which environment you are doing some action. Actuators are the doing things, means you have hands, you have legs, on which basis you can perform any action. And what are the sensors? Sensors are the input devices, just like your 5 senses, on which basis you take some input. Without taking some input, how you can perform some action, then it will be just like a blind action. Suppose you are not able to see, means eyes, through eyes, your eyes is a sensor through which you can perceive the environment around you, on which basis you take some action. Suppose you are walking on the road, or you have seen some a pothole, then you are seeing that there is a pothole in front of you, and if you walk straight, then you are going to into that pothole. But you are having senses, you are aware, you have seen the pothole, so you can bypass that pothole by moving from that another side. So suppose you are not having senses, you are a blind person, so how you can find out that there is a pothole? So you are doing some random action, and that can be a very negative impact on your performance. So sensors are your input devices, actuators are your action devices. Understand? So if you are talking about humans, then we talk about actuators. If you are talking about machines, then we have effectors. Okay, let's see the PS representation. P for performance, E for environment, A for actuators, S for sensors. Let's have an example of an automated taxi and see how this task environment having all these points. Here agent type is a taxi driver. Now what are the performance measure criteria? That a driver must drive safely, fast, in a legal manner. Legal in the sense that if there is a red light, you have to stop your car, you have to wait until the signal allow you to move on, And there must be a comfortable trip that there's something not like zigzag driving or some rash driving. Your drive must be comfortable and the maximize profit. Maximize profit in the sense we are talking about like optimal path you are taking from the source to the destination and the way you are driving your car. Suppose you are using a lot of your clutch or so it will what will happen that fuel will burn more. So how you are driving your car, it can maximize your profit in the sense that you are investing less on your fuel so that profit will be maximum for some trip. Okay, so the next one is the environment. How environment having in the automated taxi, environment are the part of roads, traffics, pedestrians and the customers. These are the environment for a automated taxi agent. Now, what are the actuators? What are the action devices? These are the steering, accelerator, brake, signal, horn and display. These are the your action devices through which you can perform some action. And what are your input devices through which you are sensing your environment? And these are, of course, your camera, sonar, speedometer, GPS, odometer, accelerometer, engine sensors, keyboard. Can anyone tell me what is odometer? We can understand what is a speedometer through which you can find the speed, how much speed your vehicle is running right now. We know GPS, we know camera, we know sonar. Tushar is saying distance. Please elaborate. What is distance? What you are saying that what purpose? What distance it means? Please elaborate. What odometer will do for you? You can unmute yourself and speak if you are not able to. Right? He is saying that it measures the kilometer travel. Basically, you can say that it measures the distance your vehicle has traveled. It may be in kilometer or some any measurement unit you want. So this is basically the measurement of your distance. Can anyone tell me what is the backend technology on which basis your odometer find the distance your vehicle has traveled? What is the basic principle behind finding the distance a vehicle has traveled, and what sort of vehicle categories it can apply on? Can we have a speedometer on my bicycle, or we can have odometer on only those things that are moving through engines? He's saying RPM. RPM is revolution per minute. Okay. Anyone else can have some idea about this? That how odometer works, on which principle? Anyone else? Is only Tushar is taking the class right now. Vishal is saying something. Yes, sir. It also can be in bicycle. RPM is means you are counting the circumference, how many times your tire has traveled. Okay. Yeah. Anyone else? How odometer works? Okay, Tushar has told a lot of things about the odometer. He has given the crux that it works on the counting the number of revolution of your tire. There are multiple type of odometers like mechanical odometer, digital odometers, but the underlying technology is the same that you are counting the number of revolutions, and based upon that your what is the radius of your tire, on which basis you find the circumference of your tire, that in one revolution how much distance traveled by your tire, and the number of revolution can be multiplied on that circumference, and you will get the distance that you have traveled. So these are the task environment for an automated taxi: performance measure, environment, actuators and the sensor. So let's move on. That here performance measure is the indication of the success of an agent's behavior. Here, what is the performance measure? It is the indication for the success of an agent's behavior and how the success is depend upon it. If your drive is safe, fast, legal, comfortable, maximize profit if these things are depend upon the agent's success. So next one is the structure of agents. What is the structure of an agent? How we design an agent? What are the components of an agent? And how agent works? Do we need only mechanical device as an agent, or do we need some program that can drive that hardware? So let's see what is the structure of an agent. Okay, the structure of agents. The job of artificial intelligence is to design an agent program that implements the agent function, the mapping from percepts to action. Percept means whatever you are taking from the environment, and then based upon that input, you process that data and take some action. So the job of artificial intelligence is to design an agent program that implements the agent function. How? So agent can be treated as a combination of architecture plus program. You need some architecture and then some program is there. So the structure of an architect. Amit Kumar has written something, architecture. Yeah, you can say structure, architecture, you can take use those words interchangeably. There is not any issue. You can go for architecture or some structure. These are the same thing, and there is not any difference. So let's see what is an architecture. Computing device with physical sensors and actuators. And then the architecture makes the percepts from the sensors available to the program, runs the program, and feeds the program's action choices to the actuators as they are generated. What is the purpose of using the architecture? Architecture basically is your building block, is your hardware on which basis you are doing some action. You need some robotic arms for a machine to pick some weight or something. So this is the architecture, makes the percepts from the sensors, that is your input devices, available to the program, runs the program, and feeds the program's action choice to the actuators as they are generated. And the program we choose has to be one that is appropriate for the architecture. This is very common sense thing, that the program you are choosing for that architecture that will be implemented as an agent, that has to be appropriate for the architecture. If the program is going to recommend actions like walk, the architecture had better have legs. If you are programming for some walk for a robot, then you must be aware that your robot must have legs, only then it can walk. So what are the different type of agent programs? Let's see. First one is simple reflex agent, means it is a very simplest category of an agent in which it take decision on the basis of input on any given point of time. Then we have model based reflex agent, goal based agent, utility based agent, and last, learning agent. We will take one by one each and every agent program, and we'll study how these different type of agent programs work to achieve the goal desired. So first one is simple reflex agent. The simplest kind of agent is the simple reflex agent. Why it is the simplest kind of agent? Because these agents select actions on the basis of the current percept only, and they ignore the rest of the percept history. It just like if you have studied design and analysis of algorithm, this same kind of situation arises in one of the algorithms. Can you name that algorithm? We have dynamic algorithm, we have greedy algorithm, right? So where you can relate with this algorithm, which take decision on the basis of current percept only, and it ignores the rest of the percept history, means it did not taken into account any previous data they are having or any future thing that can be happen to optimize your result. In greedy algorithm, what we do? Do you remember your design and analysis of algorithm subject? How greedy algorithm work? Did anyone remember how greedy algorithm works? Anyone out there? What is the principle behind greedy algorithm? Can we relate this line with the greedy algorithm? Yes or no? Anyone out there remember? Have you remember greedy algorithm? No one? There are 31 participants. One is me. So apart from me, there are 30 students are there. Amit is saying solution piece by piece. Okay, it is solution piece by piece, of course, but I am asking what is the underlying technology behind greedy algorithm? What is the underlying concept of a greedy algorithm? How it works? Anyone remember? No one? Okay, give an example of a greedy algorithm problem that we have solved. Just one example. Do you remember knapsack problem? What is a knapsack problem? Anyone remember? Okay, leave it. I guess 5 to 6 months after that. Tushari is saying highest profit. And how you are deciding that highest profit at what point of time? Are you deciding the highest profit on the current percept or basis of all the previous history of transactions? Savan is saying profit and weight ratio. And profit and weight ratio on the current basis, na? Okay, leave it. If you want to revise, you can go. Always go back and check your notes about greedy algorithm. I am just asking you to relate what you have studied previously so that this new subject is not taken as very new to you, because you have studied a lot of stuff till now. You are in the final year. So just try to relate. If it is not a relatable 100%, then you can relate it to 90%, 80%, 70%, or at least 50%, whatever you have learned till now. So if you are able to connect anything from your past to these new things, then it will be very useful for you to make the concept and to increase your imagination power to understand the new things you are having in your life, whether it is a professional or your personal area. So let's see how architecture of a simple reflex agent. Here we are having an environment. Here we are having an agent. Now agent and environment relationship is how that agent must take input from the sensors and you are taking input from the environment. So from environment you are taking input through sensors. Now what the world is like now in a current percept, in current point of time, you are looking for what the world is like now, then on which basis you will decide what action I should do now and what will give you the reasoning behind it, means the rules on which you will decide what action should I do now. Condition action rules. Suppose if it is raining, you have to take umbrella, right? What is the world is like now? It is raining outside. And what is the condition action you are already having in your program, that if it is raining, you have to take umbrella with you if you are going outside. So based upon the current situation of the world outside, that is in the environment, you are taking decision already feeded into your database, that what is the condition right now in a present scenario, that it is raining outside, you have to take umbrella if you don't want to get wet. So now, based upon this real-world situation presently, you have taken some action through your actuators. Means you are having some actuators, some action devices on which basis you are taking your umbrella in your hand and walking outside or walking in the environment. So this is the very simplest reflex agent. Reflex means whatever the percepts you are getting through your sensors, through your input devices, you are taking action right now. Understand? So this is on very simple basis, simple reflex agent. You take actions on the basis of what is the world is like now. Okay, so let's see. The next one is model-based reflex agent. How it is different from reflex agent? It can work in a partially observable environment and track the situation. Means you don't have a lot of rules on which basis you are gonna decide. It depends upon some factors. First one is model. It is knowledge about how things happen in the world. You model already that knowledge regarding how things happen in the world, and then the internal states. It is the representation of the current state based on the percept history. Percept history, you are understanding what is the meaning of percept history. Means regarding some situation, what are the previous data you are having with you? What are the previous sequences of actions you have performed in those earlier situation whenever that situation arises in the past? So that all data is with you. This is called percept history. So, how the world evolves and how the agent's action affects the world. First one is on the basis of how the world evolves right now and previously and in future, and how the agent's action affect the world. Agent's action also affect the world because through actuators you are performing some action on the environment or in the environment on that also affecting the world. So this information is used to update the agent state. Let's see how it is updating the agent state. Here again, we are having an agent and we are having an environment. Now, how environment is interacting with the agent and how agent is interacting with the environment. Now, once again, firstly see the similarities, then we can add how the new things are added to make this model-based reflex agent better than reflex agent. So what are the similarity to the reflex agent? Simple one. You are having sensors. In agents, you are having input devices, your sensors through which you are perceiving the environment. Now, what the world is like now, and you are having condition action rules also, and you take action in normal scenario in the reflex agent. But how in model based reflex agent, what the additional things we are doing, we are having the state of the environment and how the world evolves and what my actions do. If you are taking umbrella or you are going with your car, what action will be affect the world, how it will affect the world. These are the new things added to make it more useful than that simple one that the reflex agent. So three things are added apart from the previous model, that state, that is the model knowledge about how things happen to the world and how the world evolves and what your actions gonna do. So how the worlds evolve and how the agent's action affect the world. And these things are also taken by the sensors in deciding what is the world is like now, and then we apply the condition action rule, and then actuators perform the action decided by the agent. Next one is goal-based agent. As the name suggests, we are looking for goal. As in previous reflex agent and the model-based reflex agent, we are not having the goal in front of us. We are just doing or performing action on the basis of present scenario. Now, this goal information will add cherry on the cake that you are moving in the right direction. So how this is gonna happen? Goal information that describes situation that are desirable. Expand the capabilities of the model-based agent because knowledge of the current state environment is not always sufficient to decide for an agent to what to do. You must have a goal with you that your goal is to complete your Bachelor of Technology and having a standard job for you. This is the goal for you. And what is the present action you are taking to achieving that particular goal that you have some honorable job for you? You have to understand the subjects you have in a Bachelor of Technology because these subjects can add quality to your knowledge and your overall personality on which basis you are going to perform in future and achieve your desired goal. So how it is adding quality to other previously reflex agent, model-based agent. Here we are adding goal also. Here again, you can see agent is interacting with the environment through the sensors, and we have all those previous things like state, how the world evolves, what my actions do, and here also you can see the how the world evolves is having what it will be like if I do action A. Means you are having some kind of activity is that if you are doing some action, what will happen? And do we are in the right path? That is, a goal must be kept into the mind to do some action. So this is a simple structure of a goal-based agent. And in the last, we are having utility-based agent. Here, you don't think of utility just like your basic amenities like water, electricity. These we are not talking about those utilities here. Utilities here, we are talking about quality of being useful. Means how useful the actions you are doing, on which basis that you will achieve your desired goal. So what are the utility-based agent? You are having simple goal-based agent. Now you can see that goal-based agent is previously like reflex agent. Then we have model-based agent. Then we have goal-based agent. We are having all those capabilities. Then we added one more thing, one more quality, that is the utility measurement capability. Means how useful your actions are, which can achieve your goal. It is useful when there are multiple possible alternatives and an agent has to choose in order to perform the best action. You are talking about utility, that means quality of being useful and how you will decide that you are doing some useful work if you are performing action A or performing some action B, then you must be having some choices. Right, if you are having some choices like choice A, choice B and choice C, then on which basis you will decide that if you are going for some choice one, then what will happen? Is it a quality of being useful of a choice A or choice B or choice C? So these are the things we have added, because in real situation we are always have some choices. Like right now it is about 9:30 a.m. You have a choice of having a breakfast or not attending the class. You are having a choice to attend the class very dedicatedly and understand what everyone is studying. You are having another choice that you go to your bed and go for a sleep, or even don't wake up at 9 a.m. for the class. You have a choice that you have a breakfast along with your class. Kamlin is asking a question that what could be the best agent type? Best agent type, of course, that you have seen that what are the limitation of a reflex agent, that it is taking decision on the basis of current situation only. Then in model based, we have added some more qualities, but it is not looking for goals. Then we have goal based model, that it has added one more quality that we must kept into the mind, that goal must be there. Then we have not understand that in a real situation, we have a lot of choices to frame our future and to perform some action, and then decide that in lot of choices, which choice will be useful for you. So of course, we are till now, what we have studied, that utility-based agent is adding one more quality, that you have to refine your choices on which basis you will take some decisions. So till now, what we have studied, that utility-based agent outperform other reflex agent, your model-based agent, goal-based agent, and one more thing, that these agents also depend upon the context of your problem. Suppose you are having a very simple problem, then why you are going for utility-based agent or something else? As we can say that if there is a work of there is a work of a needle, then why you sword, right? So it all depends upon what sort of problem you are having, on which basis you will fit a model on that. That we will decide, like in machine learning, you have a lot of models are there, but based upon some situation and the data set you are having in your hand, we decide which model will fit that in that data set. So on which basis you will say that this model will outperform other models. So it all depends upon the data set you are having in your hand in the machine learning, just like here in artificial intelligence. It all depends upon the type of problem you have in hand, on which basis you will decide in that scenario which agent will perform very well in that scenario. So here is another diagram of utility-based agent. Here you can see we are having one more tab, that is how happy I will be in such a state. Happy in the sense we are talking about how better decision you have taken based upon all those choices. As I suggest that you are having multiple choices, like you can sleep, You can have breakfast, you can eat, you can talk to someone else, you can do WhatsApp while going this online class, you can perform any other work because I'm not able to see that you are giving concentration on this particular topic or not. I am not aware the kind of situation you are there, that you are sitting in, on your table, on your bed, or where, that I am not aware. So it is up to you. It is all your choices to you that how you are taking these online classes, that you are thinking that it is useless or something else. But the thing is, out of those choices, if you are picking up some choice, then how happy you will be after such a state. So this is the utility, this is the measurement of the quality of decision you are taking, and you know that choices makes a man future, nothing else but the choices. And there are a lot of choices in your life, and you have to, it is the you only that you are picking one choice out of an n number of choices out there, and this, the decision you are taking, you must be firm on that. That you don't want to take the class, don't take the class, and you must be aware about the consequences of that. And that in the examination, that all the steps will become as and when it is important for not. So if you are learning by yourself, it is up to you that you know that if you are not having 40 minutes to understand these lectures or just sitting around there because you all are having all notes in your Google Classroom. Excuse me. You don't have to write anything. You just have to sit and put your concentration for 40 minutes on your computer screen or on your mobile phones and listen very carefully what are the things someone wants to give you and add your knowledge. So it all depends upon the situation and the utility of your decisions. So I am briefing this diagram very quickly as the 1 minute is left only. So agent is interacting with the environment through the sensors and all the previous state, how the world evolves and what my actions do. And what my actions do also decide what the world is like now and what I will be like if I do action A or action B and how happy I will be by taking that particular decision. And then we will decide what action I should do now. And in the end, we are having actuators that will perform your task by doing a lot of stuff on this basis. One more we are having, that is learning agent. This is the conceptual components of the learning agents are learning elements, critic, performance element, problem generator. We will discuss in the next class as only 1 minute has left. So I will revise in the next class. Today's lecture also. So till then, keep studying. I will upload today's lecture class note in the Google Classroom. You can study from there also. And we will revise today's class once again as the last topic, that is the learning agent has missed